What is going on, friends? We're here with Black Bloom versus Ample for Ulti. This is a round 5 loser bracket, if I'm not mistaken. This is game 1. And yeah, looking at the teams, I assume this is a Solvice, Majorna, a Choice, Scarf, Cortana. Is that Azim of Zygarde, Azim of Coco? A defensive Lando and an SD Mega Pinsir, and Black Oblivion has some rain. Just from what Black Oblivion uses quite often, I assume there's a Sky Strike Lando. He uses that like I've seen him use that a lot, but it could also be Zemove Coco. Like, one of the two is the Zemove user. Will be interesting to see if this is a Damp Rock or Specs Pillipara. Definitely this is a Spec Kingra for sure. And this is gonna be a Spikes Pharaoh and a Rocks Lando, obviously. I assume he doesn't have a Scarfra, he has just a Swift Swim Kingdra and a Fake Out on Medicham as his speed control. So looking at it, I would assume that Empo is gonna leak with the Coco. Because if Ferrothorn comes out, he can potentially taunt it. If a Pelipper comes out, he can U-turn or Volt Switch on that, depending on his set, obviously. Some Coco also carry HP Fire, so Black Oblivion might want to scout for that. Because Specs HP Fire would do a lot. We have seen that in tour play sometimes. Yup, there it is. And he goes for Gyro Ball, does a lot. I assume Black Oblivion predicted him to go for Taunt there. I'm pretty sure this is a Chopple Berry Ferrothorn. So I assume that they're gonna exchange hazards here. Or HPIs. So, whatchamacallit. There's the Sky Strike that I was talking about, that he used that a lot. But yeah, he's gonna die to the next HPIs. And Scarf Katana, if that is, like, I think it should be Scarf Katana. Ferrothorn is now weakened, so Scarf Leaf Blade looks really threatening already, and we are just 2 minutes in. That's already looking scary. So Medicham is most likely gonna go for Zen Headbutt here. I mean, he can go for Ice Punch if he doesn't want to risk missing. But I would probably go for Zen Headbutt here overall. Let's hit everything the hardest. Majorna's not a switch into to even Ice Punch because Rocks Up, and with the Ice Punch chip, like not even but Rocks Up, but Majorna takes like 90-ish from HJK, I think. It takes a lot, so pretty much it's not a counter after Ice Punch and Rocks. I assume Empo just has to sack his lander here. That's what I'm thinking, at least. Like, it's not like he has a switch in. Yeah, he goes for Zen, I agree with that play. Takes some helmet damage, and he can now go into Scarf Katana here, or in the Pinsir. Scarf Katana is a bit more threatening. He could also go on a Specs Coco again. I'm pretty sure. I don't know if it was confirmed Specs, but it did 71 to a Ferrothorn. That looks like Specs to me. Since this Ferrothorn, I should definitely have some sort of Spadef investment to check Greninja. Especially talking about Battle Bond Greninja here. So yeah, well, it's either going Coco or Katana here, I'm pretty sure. Yeah, if you guys couldn't tell, Empo is on an alt King Napoleon. So if he goes into Cortana here, I assume Black Oblivion would go into his Ferrothorn and hoping that he would go for Leaf Blade, because Ferrothorn can obviously take two Leaf Blades, as there is the Cortana. If he would have gotten the Coco, I assume he would have just gone for T-Bolt then, because even if Black Oblivion goes into his own Coco, that would take a fuckload, because Coco is not the best Spadef, and Electric Terrain T-Bolt is pretty strong, with Specs especially. But I'm pretty sure Medicham dies at the range it's at from a Leaf Blade. If he goes for Sacred Sword breaking the Ferrothorn, this guy's Jesus. I'm pretty sure he can defog. Yeah, he can defog here, or he can Leaf Blade. Or Sacred Sword, depending on what he wants to predict. But I would probably Sacred Sword trying to predict the Ferrothorn. He's never sacking his Medicham here. And Ferrothorn is low already. So like, I would probably Sacred Sword here, because if you go for Scarf Defog, I think this has to be Scarf Defog since he has a pincer. But if he goes for Scarf Defog here and the Ferrothorn comes out, the Hazards will just go back up, so there's no point in defogging, I think. So either have to Leaf Blade. Leaf Blade is the safest play, what am I saying? Like, Sacred Sword would be a fire play, but yeah, in case he makes a different play and doesn't go in the Ferrothorn. I think he predicted the Sacred Sword actually, he went in the Pelipper. So yeah, Leaf Blade was overall the safest play because there's a Medicham in front of you. And Ferrothorn was already low. Pelipper gets 2-hit KO'd. I'm not sure if that means... I think this is just max HP. But some defense investment. I think this is the first time rain goes up, so we don't have information about this, if it's how many turns the rain stayed up. So like, I will pay attention, turn 7 rain goes up. I will pay attention to how long the rain stays up, and then we will find out if it's a Specs Pelipper. Black Oblivion is gonna go into Ferrothorn here because he doesn't wanna let this die, and he doesn't wanna give this a free beast boost. But yeah, I almost messed up there. Leaf Blade was obviously overall the play to make. Sacred Sorting, that would have been a wild play, and it wouldn't have worked out as well. So he goes on Ferro on the next Leaf Blade, does 11. I assume he's gonna Leech Seed or double out here. What is Empo gonna do? He might. Nah, I don't think he's gonna stay in because Leaf Blade only 3 hit KOs, and he would have to take Iron Burps and stuff. And he could also get knocked off and lose his scarf. Having a scarf is nice for Coco. Yeah, just in general, I don't see him staying in at all. I can see Black Oblivion potentially doubling into Kingdra here. Because Kingdra pretty much is fine here. As he goes into Zygarde. Like, if he went to Zygarde or Pinsir, Kingdra covered both pretty much. So I thought he would have gone to Kingdra there. As I figured he would have potentially gone to Pinsir or Zygarde, okay. So he goes into Zygarde. I assume this is a Z-move Zygarde, or it could also be like the Berry Zygarde with the Aggrav Berry or whatever it's called. That heals you 75% of 50%. Was it 50%? I think it was 50% if you get to 25. Okay, so he has better internet, but the timer is gonna be turned off if he gets too low, I think. So yeah, what Black Olean is gonna do here, let me think. This is a tough turn, because if this is Subcoil Zygarde with Dragon Dance, and I don't think he's that double that. Like, he could be he could be Coil DD with 1000 arrows and then either E-Speed or Outrage. And then I assume he has a Z-move. Like, it could also be a Guaf, but I'm thinking this is a Z-move Zygarde. Since the Coco was already Specs and this Majuna has to be Assault Vest. This is Z-move. If he has Coil here, that's a potential play for him. Because Coiling here means he takes the next Gyro Ball better. Yeah, Black Oblivion just had to attack, and he had to Gyro Ball as well, because if he leeched on a potential sub, like, I don't think he has sub, but just in case, he could not afford to leech seed. I mean, he has to DD again to outspeed some stuff like Kingdra. I mean, now he has to, okay, that was odd. Because, like, now he's still at plus one, which means he doesn't outspeed Kingdra. So he could have just see arrows and kept some health, but I don't think it makes a huge difference, like, it plays a huge role. He's gonna have to go into Kingdra here and click Surf. And I'm pretty sure Empo is just gonna sack this. If he has E-Speed, he can get off some nice damage on the Kingdra. But yeah, Medicham's Fake Out, I don't think it kills, but a defense boost especially. Coco obviously is slower and dies to 1000 arrows, so is Pelipper the slower and dies to 1000 arrows, so he has to go in the Kingdra and click Surf. And yeah, like I said, Empo's gonna sack this, and after that, if he has E-Speed, that might bring Kingdra in range from Pinsir's Quick Attack. If he doesn't have E-Speed, he is gonna have to go into his Assault Vest Majuna after. Like, that's what I'm thinking, I'm thinking he's Assault Vest, like I've mentioned a few times. Yeah, I might have to pause it. Okay, phew, he finally makes a move. I thought he defeated again. He didn't, never mind. So yeah, he's gonna click Surf. He does the E-Speed. Not quite sure if that's Quick Attack range. That's 60. I thought it would have been like 65. Kingdra took it a bit better than I thought it would. So that's the Majuna, and Majuna kind of gets a kill here with Flurkin. I don't think Ice Beam would kill, because Assault Vest Majuna usually wants, at the moment, like 200 HP, a lot on Speed Death, and then only 56 or so in Special Attack, so Ice Beam might not kill. So I think he's just gonna have to go for a Flurkin, and it does a lot to everything. The only one that can take a hit is, I think the Coco is still at full right, so the Coco might be able to take one, but everything else dies to Flur. He doesn't want to sack his Pelipper, because the rain ends after this turn. I'm pretty sure he was Damp Rock, right? I think he started the rain at turn 7. And it will end after I turned 14. So that, I think it's Landbrook, yeah. Because yeah, he needs the rain to have speed control to out, because Kingdra and Rain outspeed Scarf Katana, I'm pretty sure, right? It should, I hope I'm not messing up, it should outspeed Katana and Rain. So he definitely has to keep Pelipper, so he's either gonna have to sack Medicham or Coco here. And Coco is more valuable because Coco checks Pinsir, so he's gonna have to sack Medicham here. Yeah, like there's no doubt in my mind. He's just gonna sack the Medicham here because, like I said, Coco is his best check to Pinsir. And his the other 2 months are needed for to Pelipper to get the rain up, Kingdra to outspeed the Scarf Katana, and also that's another one that outspeeds Pinsir. So he's gonna go, I think, into Coco here since the Magearna's at -1. Like, it got a solar boost, but it's still at -1 because Florkan drops you by 2 stages, the special attack. He's gonna go Coco here, and I'm thinking he's also specs Coco because his lander was already Z-move. And physical Coco is not really a thing unless you run a Z-Wall Charge. And since he already has Z-move, he cannot be Z-Wall Charge. So he's probably just gonna click Thunderbolt here. keeping this healthy is nice for Empo because even after Spikes and Rocks, this can take a Surf and a Rain from Kingdra, I'm pretty sure, if it's AV and the set that runs a lot of Spadef, the Sassy one. They run Sassy because you want slow Volt Switches versus stuff like Celesteela. And sometimes they run Iron Head as well, that's also why they run Sassy, so that you don't lower your attack or special attack stat. And you can still retain decent defense stats, and not you don't have to lower your nature of your defense or attack stats. Majora, like every Majora, doesn't need the speed at all. It's just a really great pivot, one of the best pivots in the tier. It comes in on so much stuff and volts out, it's amazing. Not as much of a threat as the Double Dance set, but also kind of needed to check to keep the Double Dance Majora in check. But yeah, Black Oblivion doesn't lose anything here from clicking T-Bolt. Empo might go into his own Tapu Koko. Oh, he might. I'm not sure if Volt Switch would bring this in range from Scarf Leaf Blade. If Volt Switch. No, I don't think he's staying. I don't think he's staying in, like I said, he wants this to be out of range from. Hydro Pump and the rain from Kingdra. I said Surf earlier, I think, but I meant Hydro Pump. I assume Hydro Pump and the rain from Kingdra specs does around 65 ish, maybe 70 do. No, it doesn't do 70. It's like 60-ish, I would assume. Because if it does 70, that would mean it kills the Majora. I'm pretty sure it does less. Like, after Hazards, the Majora is gonna be at 66, I think, yeah. Something like that. Because Spike, I think that's like 12.5, the first Spike, or was it 10? And the Rocks do, I think, 6.1. If it's resisted, Rocks do like 6.25, right? If I'm not mistaken. But yeah, back on, it's gonna click T-Bolt, and Empo is... either gonna go Pinsir or Coco because he needs his Scarf Katana. Scarf Katana can revenge the Coco if he gets some prior chip damage. Okay, he fixed the issue. Timer can be back on. If he gets some prior chip damage on this Coco, then Scarf Katana can revenge this. And pretty much Scarf Katana gets a kill if it comes in on a Coco that takes some prior damage because Pelipper is already in range from Leaf Blade. Kingdra obviously cannot switch in, especially when there's no rain up. I mean, even if there was rain up, I'm pretty sure Kingdra is, I think Kingdra is at 40% if I recall correctly. So yeah, even if there was rain up, it couldn't switch into Cortana, that's what I'm trying to say. So yeah, I think Empo is gonna give up. I think he's gonna give up his Tapu Koko, if I'm being honest here, he's gonna go to Koko. Because Pinsir still has a priority quick attack. And yeah, exactly, so he sacks the Coco. I actually forgot that it was that low. Yeah, Pinsir still has quick attack, which would bring this in range potentially from Leaf Blade from Cortana. I'm surprised that he goes hard to Cortana. Maybe I miscalc and Cortana can O. If Cortana can O Coco, then I miscalc, then it's my bad. I thought Leaf Blade. I saw Leaf Blade only does like 80%. If Leaf Blade doesn't kill though, it might bring, like I said, in range from Pinsir's quick attack. So that might be what, yeah, I think that's what Empo is going for. He's definitely gonna Leaf Blade here. I can see what he's going for, never mind, yeah. Because if he weakens this, even if it doesn't Oko, this is the Pinsir check. The Pinsir check gets then weakened. If Pinsir gets an SD up, No, Pinsir doesn't SD on anything, but Quick Attack might actually do 40% to Kingdra. I don't think so, because Aerial got nerfed as well. Yeah, but pretty much he has his Assault Vest Mijuana in the back to take a hit from Kingdra. So I think Empo is still fine. So he clicks Leech Blade here for sure. I think Black Oblivion is gonna sack his Pelipper because he wants this healthy to check the Pinsir. So he's gonna sack his Pelipper here. Then he's gonna go into Kingdra and click Water Move. Empo then has to, I think, sack his Pinsir. Then he has to go into Assault Vest Mijuana and click Flare Cannon. I think that's how it's gonna go down. So he goes Pelipper, the Leaf Blade is gonna come out. Pelipper goes down, he gets an attack boost from the Beast Boost thingy. Mm-hmm. He's gonna go for Hydro Pump or Surf. He might be tempted to go for Pump. If Pump has a chance to kill Mijuana, then he definitely has to go for that, I think. But I assume the Mijuana is spadef enough to even take a Pump in the rain after Hazards. But he has Salt Vest. But yeah, this game was quite, let's say, refreshing. I've seen some other games that, like, I like offensive teams like this. And the game is like, it's 16 minutes to recording, but I think it was only because Black Olivian's net died at one point. Overall, this is a fire game to watch. And yeah, game 2 will be in a separate video. Potential game 3 will be in a separate video. I'm not gonna spoil it if you don't know the result. I'm pretty sure. Yeah, some people will already know the result, obviously. But yeah, I think he's gonna sack. Yeah, is he gonna sack his Pinsir here? Yeah, he's gonna sack his Pinsir. Then he goes to Mijuana. He clicks Flurkan with Mijuana. Because I don't think Ice Beam kills, like I said earlier. Yeah, so Surf easily doesn't kill, but like you guys can see, as you guys can see, that did nothing. What the fuck, 39? That did nothing. Okay, so Pump wouldn't have even done 60. That was a miscalc on my... And it doesn't even kill the Coco. So now he gets the chip damage that he needs on the Coco. And now Leaf Blade wins the game. Damn, that was close. Wait. If he went for Pump, the Mijuana might have died. But yeah, thank you guys for watching. I'll be right back with game 2. Well, I'm not right back, but like 1 or 2 hours later. And hope you all enjoyed. Good God. That ending was kind of weird, though. That was so close. And I underestimated Mijuana's bulk. It took the Surf way better than I thought. But yeah, peace out, friends.